Since the night Trayvon Martin was killed, we've heard a lot about Florida's Stand Your Ground law. Here's a look at exactly what that statute says. A person who is not engaged in an unlawful activity and who is attacked in any place where they have the right to be not has no duty to retreat and has the right to use force, including deadly force, if they reasonably believe such force is necessary to prevent death or great bodily harm to themselves or another, or to prevent the commission of a forcible felony. WESH 2's Amanda Ober continues our team coverage with a look at how this law will impact the case. Amanda?
If George Zimmerman's attorney decides to argue that his client is immune from prosecution under Florida's Stand Your Ground law, a judge will be asked to make a decision about that long before this ever goes to a jury trial.
WESH 2 legal analyst Richard Hornsby says a Stand Your Ground hearing is the equivalent of a full-blown non-jury trial. The defense would call witnesses first.
They would put on whatever witnesses they discover that support George Zimmerman's claim of self-defense, and most importantly, they would put on George Zimmerman, and George Zimmerman would have to explain why it was that he came to have to defend himself, and not only defend himself, but use deadly force.
Hornsby says prosecutors would then call their own witnesses to contradict the defense arguments, something Angela Corey is prepared to do.
If Stand Your Ground becomes an issue, we fight it.
During a Stand Your Ground hearing, much of the evidence in the case would be revealed. The ultimate decision as to whether Zimmerman qualifies for immunity from prosecution under Stand Your Ground would be in a judge's hands. WESH 2 judicial expert O.H. Eaton says that is not an easy task.
It's very difficult for judges to handle these things because it's so subjective. You know, what was in the person's mind is what it is. It is whether the person reasonably believed that he was in danger of death or great bodily harm.
If there is a Stand Your Ground hearing, it would be held at some point down the road, and the motion for that would be filed by Zimmerman's attorney. In Seminole County, Amanda Ober, WESH 2 News.